in the apart from the regular study activities. This extra activities somehow gave me satisfaction. But when it came to final 10th exam, I failed. I failed in mathematics. Mathematics was the toughest subject. I never understood mathematics. I was not at all good. So I failed. After failing, I got a lot of scolding from parents. And I was feeling depressed also. I didn't know what to do. What happened is, after some coaching and other regular studies, I passed in the supplementary exam. Somehow I passed with a minimum marks. Tragedy was the government made a rules that to join the college, PUC, you must have scored 40% minimum marks to join PUC. And I had scored only 38%. I was not given chance to study in college. Then where else to go? So my father decided that I should study diploma. I told my father, I am weak in mathematics. Diploma is full of mathematics subjects. I will not be able to pass. Don't waste money. But he told, no, if you cannot go to college, at least you do diploma. So he made me to pay 1,000 rupees donation. And I joined at Acharya Pathshala for doing mechanical engineering diploma. The day I joined itself, I knew that I will fail. So there was no question of trying, but I struggled hard. I studied. It is not that I just kept quiet and failed. I tried my level best, but I could pass. I failed in 7 subjects. Then I told my father, I am not going to study. He told, you finish mathematics, finish this diploma. And I told, I cannot. Then what you will do? Then I didn't know what to do. Then we had a quarrel over a friend. I had a friend whom my father didn't like, and there's a lot of stories happened, and I had a fight with my father. So then I wanted to do something, join job. Where I will go, where, what job I will join, I didn't know. So suddenly, out of the blue, I met one of my neighborhood childhood friend. His name was Kupurao. So he had come on leave from Navy. So I met him. So I asked him all the details, how he joined, what happened, how the test was. And he told me everything. He told, life is good, you can join. But make sure you will join only in the electrical branch, not any other branch. If you can't get electrical, then you go for mechanical. But electrical, you select. Then don't go in any other branch other than electrical or mechanical, like signalman, telegraphist, and there are so many branches. So he guided me. I was thinking what to do, whether to join or not. By that time, I met one more childhood friend who had come on leave from Navy. He took me to his house. He has shown me all the uniform diagrams with photographs and a band photograph and his parade photographs. And he had just passed out. So he shared all the information, and I got interested. Then I decided, I straight away went to recruiting office. Recruiting office is just opposite Mayo Hall. At that time it used to be there. So just opposite Mayo Hall, there is one army recruiting office. I don't know now whether it is operating. I went there. So I gave the test. So English and mathematics was the subject. So I wrote the exam. And I failed. I failed again. I was frustrated. How much I have to fail? Where I will succeed? What I should do? What I can do? So this was a big question mark for me. Then after some 2-3 months, I didn't know, but just I was passing through that recruiting office. I thought I will go and inquire when the next test is. So I went inside that Subedar, who is in charge of doing all the tests and other things. So he was friendly with me. So I asked him, when is the test? He told, abhi chal raha hai test. तू लिखेगा? देन आई टोल्ड आई हैवंट ब्रॉट पेन ऑल्सो. देन इट वाज मैं देता हूँ पेन, लिखना है? देन आई टोल्ड यस. ही गेव मी पेन एंड मेड मी टू सिट इन ए रूम. ही गेव मी द क्वेश्चन पेपर अदर थिंग. आई रोट द एग्जाम. When I prepared and went, I didn't pass. So what was the chance of passing now? So I just wrote the exam and went off and forgot about this test. So then I got a message after a few days that I have been selected. That was the happiest moment. I ran towards the recruiting office and I asked for everything. Then there was some problem with my documents. So that also I corrected. Then that day I was to sign the documents. That day suddenly my grandmother, my mother's mother, expired. So my parents left for Dharwad, where she used to stay. So I couldn't go because I had signed already. Then next day I was to leave. Two days after that I was to leave for Bombay. Even getting the branch, electrical branch, also was a funny story, you know, where I was given signalman branch. That one lieutenant commander Parth Sarthi was a recruiting officer. So he called me and he told, you have been given signalman branch. Your training will be in Cochin. So you will be going to Cochin. Then I told, I don't want to join. He said, why? Then I told, I don't want to go in signalman branch. I want only electrical. If electrical is there, I will go. Otherwise, I don't want to go. Then he said, no, signal man, very good branch. Then I told, no, I will not go. He said, you wait outside. He called another guy inside. He was Malayali. So I think he told, your training will be in Cochin. He was very happy. So he asked this subedar to change my warrant to Bombay and his warrant to Cochin. And that's how I got electrical branch. So then I left on 10th January and landed in Bombay for my basic training at INS Kunjali. That is the Naval Detention Quarter. That is the jail of Navy. There our basic training was started. The way the civilians are converted into defense personnel. My God, very, very tough training it is. Running, whole day running. Morning, we run with PT shoe. We run 60 rounds, 40 rounds of basketball ground. Then do PT and come back. For breakfast, you have to run with a plate. For dinner, you have to run. For lunch, you have to run. Even for restroom, you have to run. Oh, that was, if you go out of the roof, you have to start running. So we became, and after that, when parade starts, before giving the parade training, we our uniform was not naval white uniform. We have had one blue shorts and one white banyan, net banyan with blue border. And we have to wear boots and run. We were about 240 people for training. 240 people running around parade ground means we'll form the full circle of the parade ground and keep running. That instructor, he told, you will run 35 rounds. We'll start from 30 rounds. By the time we finish the training, we will run 45 rounds. So 30 rounds with boot. My God, it was after 2 days, you know, because of this boot and 200 people running around that parade ground, that soil became very, very soft, sand-like and dusty. When we finished the two rounds, whole area used to be, you know, crowded with the dust. And our white banyan used to become orange color banyan. And we were asked to wear sparkling white banyan every day. So every day we had to wash and keep it clean, put tinopal, blue and that thing, this thing, and then wear that white uniform. it went on for one and a half months. Then after 2 months, we started having a theory class about seamanship, how ship structure is there, what is forecastle, what is quarterdeck, what is starboard side, what is port side. Everything, theoretically, it was taught to us. Then a passing out period came. That time, you just saw my photo with the uniform where INS is written. That is our ceremonial dress. That ceremonial dress those days, you need two people's assistants to wear the dress. So it is a very, very tough dress. So we had to wear boot, everything, and we had to keep that white dress, sparkling white, without any mark on the dress. So we wore that and we had a passing out parade and even some passing out drill we had. We had a wonderful passing out parade and then we left. We left and we went to, 106 people went to Valsura, INS Valsura in Jamnagar. So we went there and the remaining people went for Lonawala, where mechanical people were trained. So half mechanical people went there. 106, 108 people, we went to Jamnagar for electrical training. First day when we went to training class, as soon as we sat in the classroom, instructor came and he told, we will study 7 subjects week by week. First 3 weeks, this you will study these 2 subjects. Then after, he explained everything. And he wrote the subjects. First subject was mathematics. I was shocked. I thought, when this mathematics will leave me. So I was really worried. I had no chance of passing. But still, I thought I will try. And I got 2-3 friends in Navy who were very, very friendly with me. And they taught me mathematics. They trained me in mathematics so that I could pass. The day I scored, 50% was the passing marks actually. When I scored 68, that was the happiest moment. Even I passed mathematics also. So that gave me a lot of satisfaction. So I passed and we completed the training. Ours was the biggest batch of 106 people. That was called X-ray batch. So after this passing out, in passing out also, there was some cultural programs where I participated singing a song. Old people like my brother, he will remember that Mukesh song in Saraswati Chandra. That is Chandan Sabadan.
Yes.
That song I sang and I got second prize. So that is. Then because of my singing, from the starting of my service, because of my singing inspiration is sitting right here. That is Prakash Naik, who inspired me to sing. He is the best singer. We used to call him Kishore Kumar. So, okay. I loved singing, so I started singing and I used to have my own fans wherever I went. So that song gave me, that made me to start singing for people. So from there, after passing out, I came back on leave. Then again, I left for Cochin, where my first ship, INS Ganga, I was to join. Why I selected Ganga is also an emotional story. Why all good ships, when they allotted ships, when we passed out, all good ships were already taken by brilliant students. So I was below average student. So last it came, only few ships were remaining. And I selected Ganga because the grandmother who passed away when I signed paper, her name was Ganga. So that made me to select this ship and I went. The day I reported on board ship, I will show you the ship photograph. That has a terror ship. That is a Hunt class destroyer. This is the ship. Actually, this is the INS Godavari. Similar ship is, this ship photo is taken from my ship. So that is Godavari. And our ship is symmetric, same type of ship. It was INS Ganga. Life on board ship was very, very tough, very hard. It was because it was already old ship. It was already crossed 50 years of service. So very hard life, but somehow we learned how to face the difficulties. Sometimes when we go, we started, you know, life on board the ship. First time we had, I had an experience of one day sailing, going in the morning to the open sea. We had to do some exercise and then we came back in the evening. That was my first sailing experience. That was very wonderful experience. Sea was very calm. We went, did some exercise and came back. After some time, I think after 15, 20 days, we were to sail to Bombay. We were to sail to Bombay for a president's review. 69 December, we had a president's review by our president, Honorable V.V. Giri. He took the salute of naval fleets. 45 ships participated and it was anchored. So to participate in that, we were to leave Cochin and sail to Bombay. That was a wonderful experience. Open sea and how we feel in the open sea when we go for the first time is a really very great experience. Nighttime, pitch dark, wherever you see it is pitch dark, ship, only ship's light only you can see. Ship is moving and you can't see anything. And we all wondered how we will go and reach you. Then few navigating friends, they explained how everything is planned and done. So that is just like setting goals. Once the direction is set, speed is calculated, everything. So we go and reach on the same decided time. He said, day after tomorrow, by morning 10:30, we will be in Bombay. And I was just watching, you know, whether we will reach or not. But we can't miss. Goal is set and it is there. So we reached Bombay just at that right time. Then we had President Giri. It was a great experience. All ships participated. We had a wonderful time and a wonderful experience of sailing to Bombay. And from there we came back. We did few exercises for 1 year. 1971, February, we had a chance to go to Colombo and Maldives. And as soon as we entered Colombo, PNS Alamgir, that is Pakistan frigate, it also entered. So when we went out, we met some Pakistani sailors also. They were afraid to talk to us, but we enjoyed talking to them. So one day only I could go out in Colombo, go to their fleet club and enjoy and came back. Then we went to Maldives. Maldives also, we landed in the morning. By afternoon, PMS Alamgir came there. So after that, we came back. We didn't know why, what for we went. They said it is a goodwill visit. That December 1st, 1971, suddenly a sailing order came. Surprise sailing order, emergency sailing, and all the staff were called back to ship and we started sailing. We didn't know where we are going. As soon as we entered the open sea, they called clear lower deck. Clear lower deck means everybody assembled in one area. So we assembled and our CO announced that we are at war. So India has declared war against Pakistan. So we are at war. And what is our course and everything was given where we had to go and do the duty. See, it was somewhere around Sri Lanka. And what was our purpose? Everything was given, detail was given. whole Indian water was made out of bound for others. There should be no movement in Indian waters. So we were to see that nobody is moving in Indian waters. Our duty was that. We are not in active action area like Vishakhapatnam or Chittagong. We are not in western sector near Karachi. Other ships were there. So our three ships, turn by turn, we were doing patrolling duty around Sri Lanka. Why? Because there were some Pakistani merchant navy ships. They were carrying ammunition to Chittagong. They forcefully entered Colombo and they are harbored there. So they should not come out. So we were guarding them. We went there. Second, it was okay. I think third morning around 11 o'clock, suddenly they announced action station. Action station means we have to get ready for the action. So get ready means there will be different groups formed in different parts of the ship. We have to be there because we cannot be moving around in action time. So we have to be there. We have to look after that particular area. Action station was called. We didn't know why. So now all of a sudden, some depth charge was dropped into sea. There was a huge sound, everything, but we didn't know what was happening. After 1.5 hour of action, the action station was called off. So when we again started normal life, we asked people, you know, what happened? And they told, submarine was detected under our ship. Under the ship, they traced a submarine. So action station was called, they took permission and they wanted to blast that submarine. So we dropped depth charges. But nothing happened. Then we lost contact of that submarine. We were searching, but action station was called off. Afterwards, we didn't have any contact of that submarine. There are two things. That plotter, in charge plotter, you know, who was a cryptographer, he brought that graph sheet and he was crying. He told, wow, what a chance we had. We could have blasted the submarine. I would have got a medal and he was crying. We missed it. And the rest others, you know, they were joking. It was not submarine, it was some big fish. So you mistook it for submarine. We all joked on him, but he told, no, it was submarine. But that episode stopped there only. Then we were sailing. Fifth night or sixth morning, we got an information that mysteriously a Pakistan submarine was sunk off Vishakhapatnam. And we had a lot of stories, you know. They said we have sunk the submarine. Some said there was explosion. Oil was seen on the sea and we again dropped the ammunition and we blasted and we sunk the submarine. But totally a PNS Ghazi was sunk on fifth night. About 178 sailors and 18-20 officers, they died. It was confirmed when their dead bodies was, you know, collected from some Kananur or near Vishakhapatnam only. It was their body was floating and they collected. Then they came to know. Then divers were sent and they confirmed that PNS Ghazi is sunk. So that time we got a confirmation that what went underneath our ship was really a submarine only. That time everybody was so scared and they said, okay, we didn't blast the submarine. Okay, submarine didn't blast us. So that is another story. So that happened. Then 2 days continuous, we sailed. In between, we used to come back for fueling and then again go back. On seventh night, so our ship, you know, we had a very weak radar and our communication system. Only because of poor communication system, only we missed that submarine. So our CEO requested, you know, he made a speech and he told everybody, whenever you are moving on the upper deck, be vigilant, look here and there, even in night time, if you see a light or if you see any movement, suspicious movement, you please inform the duty officer. So a very youngsters like me, I was only 19, 20, 21 year old. Everyone, youngsters, you know, they want to do something and get noticed. That was my urge also. So I wanted to do something. So we used to sit on upper deck whole night up to 12 o'clock, 1 o'clock. We used to sit, keep on watching in the sea, whether we see some light or something. I don't know whether it is our assumption or something. So we, about six sailors, we were sitting and talking near engine room. We were sitting on chair on the upper deck. So we were just watching. Suddenly we saw some light, small light in the sea. So we went running to the bridge and we told the officer, "See, sir, there is light. One small light is visible." Then he too saw, then slowly we started moving towards the light. We had gone nearly that light, you know, we confirmed that it is a small ship's navigation light. Only one light was there. We went near to that, not fully near, with that distance. And all the time we were asking, you know, through light signal, they flashed the light signal. So they were asking, "Who are you? Who are you? Who are you?" They were signaling, "Who are you?" But they never bothered to answer. They never bothered to answer. And even our CO was woken up and he was called to bridge. So he was sitting there and he was also trying to get the answer from them, but it was not coming. After a prolonged time, they asked the naval headquarters also what to do. They told, "You keep asking, don't go near, don't go, don't interfere anything. Just keep asking." They kept on asking. So nearly 1 hour this drama happened. And afterwards, what happened was really one of the best view I have seen in those days. What happened is, from that nearby that light, one big reflector, nearly about 3 or 4 feet dia, that much big arc light is white light, arc light, just they opened the shutter and left. When they opened and held it for 1 minute, whole area of the ship, sea was illuminated. And our ship was just like one small, you have seen this Tom and Jerry, you know? That's, we were a small rat in front of that ship. We saw a structure of the ship, that light we couldn't see. So we held our hand to that light and we saw a very huge ship. I will never get chance to see that again. Huge aircraft carrier of very big size. We saw, then he didn't answer anything. They just switched on the light, saw us, made us to see them and closed it. Then our ship, I think they had a discussion with the naval headquarters. They told, "Just you get off that place." So we moved away. We went on our patrolling. We didn't know anything. Then on the way, we saw another two ships escort to that. Next day, we came to know that it was 7th Fleet of US. That aircraft carrier was US Enterprise. That is, that those days, it was the biggest aircraft carrier. And two American ships were escorting that aircraft carrier. So why I am telling all this? Because even though we were 140 people on board ship, only we, about 7-8 people, had a chance to see that ship for one minute. That was the greatest experience we had. Then we maintained that vigilance and we were patrolling and coming back to Cochin, getting refueled and again going back. About our own life, if we have to say, during this war period, it was so tough. There was no drinking water on board ship. There was no drinking water. Whatever the water evaporator generated was needed for boiler. It was boiler driven, steam driven ship. So major soft water was required for boiler, for bath and drinking. There was a very strict control. They used to open water for half an hour. We have to, 20 people, we have to run and have bath. And while serving the food, they will give one mug of water. We have to drink. We have to manage with that one mug for food. Then afterwards, again, you will not get water. Evening, if they serve tea, we have to keep one mug tea separate. It will cool down. You can have hot tea and again keep the tea there. When it cools down, you can drink it as water. This type of hardship we had, but it was thrilling experience. When we won the war, before winning the war, on 9th of December, it was a Black Thursday. It was Black Thursday for Indian Navy. On 10th, we learned that one of our frigate ship, INS Kukri, was sunk by Pakistani submarine off Karachi. And most tragedy was this ship, INS Kukri, was an anti-submarine frigate. And it was sunk by a submarine. That was shocking news for our sailors, we felt. But why it happened? Because generators failed and there was no power on board ship. Everything failed. So it was just floating and it became the dead target for the submarine. So they fired two torpedoes and that ship got sunk within 2 minutes. So we lost about 160 sailors and 20 officers. We had just passed out from the training. So my batchmates, about 4 electricians, they lost their life. One of our friend, his brother was there. He passed away. So many people died. So we felt very bad. But luckily, we were all depressed and worried. Next time when we came for fueling, ceasefire was announced on 16th and agreement was signed by Niazi and war was declared ended and we won the war. Winning the war, fantastic. Fantastic feeling it was. At the age of 21, I had that chance of serving for the country and participating in the war. Till recently, I never valued it, I think. Suddenly, when I came to know the last 50 years, when they said that we are celebrating the 50th year of winning this war, that suddenly it shook me. I was in that war. Oh, how precious I am. Oh, my God. What all experience I had, then I thought I will share this. And I was raring to share this information. Thanks, Pradeep, you gave me an opportunity. So I, after the war, I was there up to March of 1972. I was there. Then I was transferred to INS Angre, our naval headquarters in Bombay. And I was in a base maintenance unit. Their task was daily walk 15 kilometers. Going to ships and serving them with the repair works. I did 2.5 years. Then I was transferred to INS Amba, which is a submarine mother ship. After that, 7 months I served there. Then I got promoted. So I went to Jamnagar again for advanced training. So this is this photo of what you are seeing now is an exercise called Jack Stay, where personnels are shifted from one ship to another via rope. that is Godavari, and this structure what you see, that is Ganga, our ship, and a high level officer is being shifted from our ship. After he inspected our ship, we are transferring him to another ship in the open sea while moving, while sailing. So he's being shifted. This is called jack stay. And I will show you the, our staff during war. Not this one, another photo. This is my staff. My center one is my electrical officer and my colleagues. And I am sitting right side. No, that is myself. So this is the staff we had during war. This Sardarji, his brother expired in INS Kukri. He is the one. So then when I went back to Valsura, I finished my advanced training and got transferred to same base where I became in charge of a powerhouse. I had about 20 people in my group. That photo is also that. This is my staff. This is we gave send off to my senior who was in charge of powerhouse. So he went on transfer and I took over. If you can identify me, just see whether you can identify me. A man with a tilted head is myself. So this is after this training, and I stayed there up to 77, and I came back to Bombay, served 2-3 months on board INS Kuthar, which is sister ship of INS Kukri. And I served there for 2 months. Then that ship was handed over to Coast Guard. So I was transferred to one minesweeper called INS Kadalur. From there, I left Navy in 1979. January, I left Navy after 10 years of service. Because of my ex-serviceman certificate, I got employed in HMT, watch factory, Tumkur. I served there for 22 years. There I had ups and downs. I built my house. I couldn't retain my house. So many things happened. Then I had to take VRS in 2001. I took VRS. And I didn't know what to do. But I never wanted to work again under anybody. I had already worked 32, 33 years. So I didn't want to work. But nothing worked. I tried my business in two, three ways. I tried my business, but everything failed. My wife became my beautician, and I opened a parlor for her, which didn't work. So we lost all the money, and I didn't have anything to live upon. So I was just thinking what to do. By that time, I came across a network marketing opportunity. I tried my level best, but because of reasons, I couldn't pursue that business. So I left. And I was thinking what to do. By the time, my wife advised you, why don't you go to your friend and ask him to help you? I went and asked. Fortunately, he was kind enough to help me. And I entered again to the work field in Divyashri Developers. It saved my life. This Divyashri Developers, when I joined, really it was a support given to a sinking man. So I served in there 11 years and I got retired in 2014. While serving in Divyashri, I could fulfill all the responsibilities I had. I got my daughter married. My son got settled with his job, with his work. He started his own practice, tax consultant practice. So he stabilized his business. So I wanted to work for some more time, but My son told, no, you have done enough now. 43 years you have worked. So you need not work again. I just relaxed for 2 years. Then I couldn't stay home idling. So I went around and one of my nephew, he did a counselor's course and he told, uncle, you do this. This suits you and you love this. Why don't you do it? So I told, okay, I will do it. So I went and did counselor's course and I liked it. I could help people who are in distress, who are depressed. So when I was in network marketing, I got into a lot of reading, I read nearly 200 books about personality development and mindset changing, thinking, subconscious mind, success principles, and so many things I studied and got that knowledge. So with the same knowledge, I could do the counseling. So I did that course and weekly one day, I used to go and help people. So that gave me a lot of satisfaction, but still I was not happy. I wanted to do something. That time I came across while reading, after coffee, I was reading a newspaper and suddenly I came across a training program, that is Train the Trainer program, which said, you will be made a trainer. That interested me. I saw the subjects. There was no mathematics. So all the subjects were good, except for the investment part. I was thinking everything is fine, but investment part, I don't know from where I will get. Anyway, if God thinks that I should do it, I will do it. I liked the course. So I attended the preliminary seminar and came back. Somehow I got into, with the help of kind people, I entered the training program. But unfortunately, just after finishing about 10, 15 weeks class, weekend class, I had health issue. I was admitted in hospital and they advised a surgery. I told, no, I don't want to spoil my virginality. I will get treated by Ayurvedic and see that I'll be okay. I took the treatment, but it was okay. One day I went out with my son and family and I ate a little more. And that day I felt very odd, then I was admitted again. So that was the time during a lockdown, heavy lockdown. So I was taken to hospital. Then they said, you have to undergo surgery. There is no question, bypass surgery you had to do. We will not leave you. You will undergo bypass surgery. Then I got admitted. Then surgery was done on February 24th. So February 29th, I got discharged, but I knew I cannot go to training. Classes were running, so I was worried what I will do, whether I will be attending class or not. My son clearly told me, nothing doing, you will not move out of the house. Forget about training. Then I told, okay. Then that is the time, because of Corona, the training stopped. The training stopped, classes stopped. So it gave me time to recover. So I was recovering. Unfortunately, April 24th, I think, 14th, I had a severe breathing problem with great difficulty. My son could take me to hospital and they said, we can't give you any surety. I came to know afterwards. They told my son, we can't give any surety. There is water around lungs we have to remove. 48 hours, we can't say anything. We will treat him. So they treated me. I became all right and I stayed in hospital for 10 days. And then I got discharged. I became okay and I came back. Luckily for me, see, when it is destined that I should be doing something, God will help. So I think I was to become a trainer. So God helped me. So we were having some gathering, you know, small group gathering in webinar because of one of my friend's effort. So there I was to talk about my life. Inspiration talk. So that day I was talking, and the founder of that training company, he was also there. Then I requested him, why don't you start the training online? So that was the only chance for me to complete the training. Offline means I will not be allowed to attend the training. So he got inspired with the webinars we were doing. So he took initiative and started the course online. So sitting at home, I got to learn from the course. Everything happened on November 29th, the first day of my 71st year. I got graduated from IITD and became a trainer. That was very, very happy moment for me.
Great, sir.
In my life.
We need to learn from you. Yes.
lot of zeal and energy was there to share my experience and my thing before also, but I didn't have any authentic certificate to show that I am a trainer. I will speak. I will do this. I didn't have. So when I got that certificate in my hand, when we collected the hard copy of the certificate last week. So when I held that certificate in my hand, I felt thrilled. So that graduation made a lot of encouraging thing in my life. So then I was thinking, what area? After graduation, what? So I set the goal. With my knowledge, my spiritual knowledge and this personality knowledge and what all I learned from my ITD during this graduation period, what all I learned, I will use all this knowledge and try to help at least. I don't know why that figure, but I want to impact 20 lakh people's life. That became my target. Yes, money, want money, but first I want to serve people. That was from the starting, I was like that. I was interested in people. I was helping wherever I worked, whether it is in Divyashri or in HMT or Navy. I used to have big group of people who used to love me and adore me. Most of the times it was because of my singing. After leaving Navy, there was nobody who said, you sing, I will listen, but nobody was there. So only in IITD, when the chance came, I told, when last day of our training, we had a class, then I told one of my colleague, Vinita, she was preparing some Thanksgiving program. Then I don't know what made me. I remembered my olden days, how I used to prove myself separate. So I wanted to sing. So I told I'll sing and I sang. I thank God all my friends liked it. So,
yeah, we want you to sing today also, sir. We want the same spirit today. Yeah. Sure. And, you know, to get everybody into that state of mind.
Anyway, yeah. I wanted to sing because I had a lot of naval sailors, you know, my friends who used to sit and listen to me for hours. Once when I was in Jamnagar, one fellow, Rajasthani Jat, he was a basketball player. He was mad behind my singing. He always wanted to hear sad songs. He never used to know which song. So like that. When I say, if I'm not in mood, he used to go to family quarters, knock somebody's door, bring one bottle of rum, pour two peg, you have this, and then sing. So that type of fan I had. So today, in this auspicious time, you know, 50th year and everything, I wanted to dedicate the one song for all those people who loved my singing, including the ITD fans. So this is about my life. I went through. Success was there, partially. Failure was there, but failure taught me so many lessons. Patience, perseverance, tolerance, discipline, so many things which I couldn't, forget and leave throughout my life. For example, I will tell you punctuality, timing. For me, it's 6 o'clock means 6 o'clock, that's all. Not even 6:01. 5 minutes before six, okay. Not 1 minute after six. So that type of timekeeping, punctuality, that discipline, what all Navy taught me has proved very good in my life. I have, all together, if I sum up, whether it is successful, yes, successful. Today, when I see this is the reward of that period.
Wow, great, sir, great, wow.
This is the medal which I got for the 1971 war.
Wow. I think I have never seen medals like this.
why I am feeling so proud of it, I will tell you, this was with me for the last 50 years, but I never valued it in that way. Today, when I looked at it, I came across a slogan. This may help everybody. I came across a slogan that says, change the way you look at things. The things you look at will change. In difficult times or when there is a problem, if we change the way we look at that problem, that problem itself will change. Same, if I have to talk about this medal was with me for the last 50 years. So what I used to think is, everybody in Navy got that medal, so I too got medal. What is so special? They didn't give you 100 rupees per one medal. If they had given 100 rupees increment, that would have given some satisfaction. They just gave me medal, what is the use? But today when I look at this medal, I will tell you one thing. Those people who joined after 71 war, that is 72, and served 20 years and got retired in 92, they didn't get any medal. They didn't get any medal at all. And how many people were there in Navy during 1971? 50,000? 50,000 people were there. All the 50,000 got the medal. How many people were there in the country? It was 50 million, maybe. But how precious this medal is. Nobody has got that medal. And I have got. Today, holding this in front of you, I feel so proud. And with all your kind permission, I want to wear this medal today. I hope you don't mind seeing it.
Please go ahead, sir. It's a privilege.
Thank you.
Salute you, sir. Salute you.
This is my...
Narendra, you earned it.
Yeah.
So you have to wear it.
Yes.
And while you are proud, we are also proud of it.
Thank you.
Very much proud of you, sir. Very much proud of you.
My wife gave me, incidentally, a medal for fighting with her.
Thank you. This is the medal. Thank you very much.
Absolutely. You look so great. Absolutely fantastic, sir. Very
Thank
nice.
You. Today
very
I nice. Feel it. How my own slogan is working on me.
Yeah.
The way I looked at this medal and the way I am looking at this medal today, it has made me very proud. Thank you for witnessing this.
Great,
it's a pleasure and honor.
So this is my story of my life. Some success, a lot of failures, but failures is not, it was a stepping stone for me to succeed. And if I look back on my life of 43 years working, I feel that I am very, very successful. My SSLC qualification, was always an inferiority complex for me. But now I proudly mention that SSLC. Why? Because it is no more a secondary school leaving certificate. According to me, it is self-studied life coach. So I proudly display.
Wow. Excellent. Can you repeat that, sir?
From today, from the day I passed out from the ITD, I made it not prominent to announce Dean Narendra Naik SSLC.
Oh, that's how I wonder you told me to put SSLC.
Yeah, I insisted. So why I say SSLC? Because now I proudly say that I am self-studied life coach or leadership coach or, like Pradeep Joseph said, even love coach. So whatever the personality issues are there, I am there. I want to solve. So this is my story. I hope everybody got something out of my this one. What I, four or five things I can tell you is patience. When there is a difficult period going, just keep calm, wait for the good days to come, it will come. Nothing is permanent, it will changing. And patience. And always, you know, try to be, I always thought that I don't belong to this group. I am different. I want to do a different thing. I want to be different. So that's how I got into singing, and very few people can sing. So I used to sing. So that's how feeling important, do something different so that you will be different. You will, if you keep on doing the same thing, you will get the same thing. So if you want different things, you have to do different things. So these are the few things which I learned during those days, I think. Unknowingly, I followed in schools also. I tried to excel in some area, some one area or the other, I used to excel and make myself known to people. So that's how I survived and kept my heart. And I fought throughout my life. And today, sitting back and viewing those years, I feel very great. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
I think we are all really very proud of you, sir, actually. Don't worry, we'll make this video viral. Don't worry. We have all the platform, social media platform and everything. I think you should share your story, actually, you know, with everybody, sir, because all these things we cannot get in the, even in the books, nobody has the patience to
read. One of our ITDNs, he told, you don't worry about any training program. You don't prepare any training program. You have got 70 years of life behind you. What all you experienced is a teaching for us. Whatever you experienced, you mention it and see how you can connect that to my life. You just do that, sir. You don't need any training program for that. That made me to start writing my experiences of Navy. And 2.5 years experience in on board INS Ganga, I started writing the adventures, accidents, mishaps, losing friend, a friend meeting with an accident, losing his leg. So many things happened there. I started writing my experience just to make 2 minutes, 3 minutes video on YouTube. That was my goal. When I started writing, then the whole things started coming out. Yeah, after every episode, I could write what you can take away from this, Then like that, if 10 episodes, I wrote half of the book, it happened. Then the idea came. Then I thought I will write a book. That my experience itself will be a book. Then one of my nephew suggested, I called it actually down the memory lane. Down the memory lane of my service. So I made that heading, name of the book. Then my nephew suggested, uncle, I will suggest one more name which suits your Navy this one. Then he told, life on the high seas is the best title for your book. Then I instant I changed it.
Yes.
Life on the high seas is the book.
Life on the high seas.
Yeah. 2.5 years service I have finished. Another 7-8 years life plus other experiences I have. I will write that one. And as Pradeep Shetty, you said, another 2-3 months I will publish that book.
Great, sir. Great. Fantastic. I have a software for that, sir. I'll just create everything and just put it across to Amazon. Don't worry.
Please, sir.
We are there to support you. We will.
You are so kind to me.
Don't worry.
Immediate platform. I am grateful to you.
Will happen automatically. Don't worry.
Mindset Club, especially
in Hindi. In Hindi, it says, Jaha chaha waha raha. You know, where there is a will, there is a way. Automatically, it comes. Sir.
Go ahead. Yes, sir. Anybody want to ask? Question. Also said you want to ask. Yeah, I got some questions.
Yeah, I also want to ask, but let's others ask questions if any. Please go ahead, sir. And we want a song from you, sir. So you'll be singing it later after the question and answer session. We want a song from you.
Okay.
Any song, whichever you feel good. Yeah.
Sure, sir. Sure.
Okay. Thank you. So anybody can please go ahead and ask Narendra sir any questions. A lot of experience. I think you talked about 1971. I was not at all born at that time. So what a great experience and great. So over to the audience.
Narendra sir. Narendra sir, Rajan here.
Yeah, Rajan sir.
Hi. Sir, precisely I was 3.5 years old when this war happened. I born in 1968 July. This happened in 71 December.
Yeah. Great.
So I still remember when the siren used to, there used to be a siren in the evening. And blackout used to be there.
Yeah.
And I still feel that kind of a fear, which I can remember very well. So all the people, they used to put, you know, papers on their window glasses.
Yeah.
And at night by 10 o'clock, we used to go on terrace. My father used to take me on terrace. And we have seen the stressors because I was in Mumbai. And to protect the aerodrome, Santa Cruz Airport, they used to throw the tracers in the sky to locate whether any, fighter plane of Pakistan is coming so that they can shoot it.
Intercept, yeah.
So I remember that, and I'm really very happy to meet you, sir, that when I came to know that you have participated in this war, I really salute you. First person I met in my life who has actually fought that war, and I have experienced that war at the age of 3.5. I have not seen the war, but I understand what kind of fear is there.
Yeah.
So thank you very much. I just want to know how when you were in the sea, moving around, how many days used to be there in the sea patrolling it?
Once you fill up the tank, once you get the fueling done, when you start sailing, we can sail 4 days.
Oh.
So 3 days we used to sail, guard those area, then come back last 4th day and again fill the fuel and go back again.
Oh.
So when we come back, another ship, there were 3 ships. One is Ganga, one is Godavari, and another one is Gomati. So we had a turn by turn. When they come for fueling, we go there. Like that. 4 days sailing, 1 day off. 4 days sailing, 1 day off. Like that. So we used to sail. You can have fueling and we can sail for 4 days.
And I've heard that when you are in the sea, basically when you are there for a longer period in the sea because of the waves, I mean, that motion sickness and all that kind of thing is there.
Normally what happens is if you sail in June, July, a true sailor is identified in the sailing of June and July.
Okay.
Because monsoon time, sea will be very rough. Right. Very rough means... Nobody can imagine. Only you have to experience that. Whole ship, it will go down like this.
and climb the waves. Climb the waves means not the waves you see in shore. In open sea, waves means only the depression down, and it climbs up like this. How much? About 30 feet. Oof. When you go up 30 feet, suddenly water goes down. And you come and bang the sea. When the water goes down, the propellers will be running. It will be very frightening sound. Propeller will be running full speed. When there is a resistance from the water stops, you know, the propeller runs full speed. The whole ship will gada 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 gada. Some noise comes and damn, that it comes and bangs the sea. Then after some time, again it climbs this wave. Apart from this forward and downward movement, there will be sideward movement also.
Ooh.
It will roll 30 degree. 30 degree it will be rolling. Seasick you are talking. It is not seasick. People vomit blood.
Yeah, oh my God.
One of our captain, when we went some June sailing for one day, he vomited blood and he was lifted, airlifted by helicopter.
So you might have not slept also?
No, you can't sleep also. You have to hold something and be sitting. And what we do, because of less movement in the ship, we will identify few people in the forward switchboard, few people in the aft backward switchboard, few people in the boiler room, few people in the engine room. They will look after those problems there. Nobody needs moving. Upper deck, you can't move. You have seen that ship. Upper deck, you can't move. One guideline they will put, that will be moving handle-like. So you have to hold that handle and move. That also, it is very difficult. So many times, you cannot move.
Sir, one
and
last
what
question.
Happens whenever the ship rolling and pitching, this sideward movement is known as rolling. And forward and downward movement is called pitching.
This pardon, sir.
Of this roller and pitching.
Repeat it, sir. Once again, repeat it.
This sideward movement like this is called rolling. Forward and upward, you know, downward and upward movement is called pitching. So roller and rolling and pitching, what we do know, when the pitching happens, whatever you have eaten, when the down it goes, it will be coming up. When it goes up, it will go down. So your body inside will shake. So you will vomit. I vomited once or twice, but I never had any blood vomit or some certain thing. I never had actually seasickness, but only once when I was in the last ship, INS Kutar, it was supposed to be handed over to what I should say, Coast Guard. So they removed all the ammunition, So ship was weightless. That time, there was a sailing order to go to Porbandar to inaugurate some merchant navy jetty that were alongside the ship goes, no? That harbor. There we were to inaugurate. So without ammunition when we sailed, even in the calm sea, that rolling, pitching, rough sea, horrible experience I had. I slept in the switchboard room for 1.5 days continuous. I never came out. 1.5 days I was lying down there. One Sardarji was there who could move around. So he brought one bottle of water and gave me. In whole 2 days, I had only one bottle of water. That was the worst sailing I had. But I never vomited or anything. But we had a tough experience of that.
Sir, last question.
Yes.
That American fleet, what you told me,
yes,
I read somewhere in one article that if that particular fleet had participated in the war, it would have been a very difficult time for India.
I will tell you a story which we heard after the war. 7th fleet came, 3 ships and 1 aircraft carrier. They entered Indian water to support Pakistan. Okay? They didn't do anything. They just came to Indian waters and went back. Why it happened like that, nobody knows. But what we learned afterwards, when American Enterprise aircraft carrier was floating above the water, there were 6 Russian submarines under those aircraft carrier. We didn't know that. 6 submarines were there. So in case of anything, if they support Pakistan, Russians would have supported us. That is one thing. Second thing, 54 Air Force and Naval pilots, they had signed for suicide attack. They had signed. They said Enterprise will not go back. If they interfere, we will go and crash on the ship itself and we'll destroy it. So 54 people at that way, emotionally, spiritually, everybody was spirited and everybody was ready to do anything. Because of Russian submarine was there underneath the Enterprise, they didn't participate. They just went back.
Thank you, sir.
We were the only 7-8 people. We had a glimpse of 7th fleet. That was a great feeling.
Right.
Good evening, sir. This is Amit Raj from Coimbatore. Really, we are thrilled to know your success as well as the experience in the Navy. Really, we salute you, sir, for your wonderful service and the war which won for us in the year 1971. Just I want to know, what's your daily routine in the ship when you are sailing, sir? What is your routine, daily routine, right from the morning till the evening?
Morning routine, unlike we are in harbor. So in harbor, we will get up at 5 o'clock and 5:30, we go for PT, then come back at 6:30, then breakfast. Then that is the run routine when we are in harbor. So when we are in sailing, we get up 6 o'clock. 6 o'clock, we again muster in front of all the staff, department staffs. We will assemble in one place. We'll do some clean ship routine. Clean ship routine is, in ship, what is the problem is? We have to do each and everything ourselves. Cleaning, sweeping, wiping, whatever, mess, electrical rooms, switchboards, all areas we have to maintain. Our areas we have to clean and maintain. 6 to 7 o'clock, 1 hour is cleaning routine. After cleaning routine, half an hour gap, 7:45, 8 o'clock, we will have a breakfast. Then after breakfast, 8:45 or 9 o'clock, we will assemble again, department-wise. Each department, now suppose electrical, I was an electrician, so electrical department, if we assemble in one place, what they will do, how the ship routine works is, few people will be given sections, lighting. 2 people, they will look after only lighting. All the lighting system of ship is maintained by those 2 people. Wherever light circuit is problem or bulb replacement or whatever it is there, they have. And 2 people will look after the ventilation, because ship will have blowers. That was not a AC ship or anything, so it was an old ship. Ventilation means blowers. Air outlet. Those air will be blowing, so that is. Okay. So some people will be doing that, and some people will look after the generator. Some people will look after the internal machinery, external machinery, like that. Sections will be divided. So when we muster in on the deck, so they will say, you look after your sections. So we go to our sections. Some complaints will come. Suppose if I am in lighting department, I will get complaints from. One of the biggest learning was when I reported on board ship, one of my senior electrician who taught me ship's duties, he told one thing. It is 50 years past, I still remember and I follow it. He said, Electrical means it is emergency. Somebody is shocked. Some burning is happening. So electrical call means it is emergency. Whichever part of the ship they call you, you have to reach there within 2 minutes. Within 2 minutes. From there will be a lot of staircases you have to climb. You have to run around. Then again climb the ladder like that. But all that you have to do within 2 minutes. So he made me to run. And even now, my wife says, walk slowly, I cannot. So I have to walk fast only. So that has become a routine now. So I have to walk fast only. That has become. So that is the routine. Then we work up to 1 o'clock. Then 1 o'clock, we will have lunch. Then after 1:45, again, there will be outpipe, they say. They'll sound the pipe, so we go and again muster. Then again start working up to 3:30, 4 o'clock. 4 o'clock, we will secure means close the work, then come back and have tea. 5 o'clock, if you are at shore, we will go for sports. Whatever, whoever wants to play sports, they can go to ground and play sports. Or if you want to go out for recreation, you want to go out, you can go out and come back before nightfall o'clock. So that is the routine. So liberty, once in 3 days, you are on watch. You're on duty. 2 days off, 1 day duty. 1 day duty means you cannot go out. You have to be on board ship. After working hours, you have to look after your particular section. Any problem is there, you have to look after that. Sailing life, it will not be that strict, but a lot of work will be there. We have to run around and work. And evenings, very pleasant. I will never forget in my life the sunset and sunrise. I used to get up early in the morning just to watch sunrise. I used to get, excited about life. So you must see in the open sea. Open sea, that when sunset is happening, that orange color, lost half sun is down and half sun is up, whole sea becomes orange. And the ship is sailing, ship's shadow will be a black border. You can imagine an orange sari with a black border. That type of beauty. And when sunset is happening, lakhs of dolphins, if you are nearby shore, lakhs of dolphins, they will jump and go. They come out to get heated up by sun. So there will be diving. You can see that is the best vision, best view of sailing. Beautiful. That sailing. And second thing I enjoyed was when firing practice happens. Whenever we sail to Bombay 3-4 times, whenever we sail near Goa, there is one island, Mud Island, they say. Just U-shape, Mud Island, it is isolated, means nobody is there. So whenever we cross that Mud Island, we do the firing practice. Our ship had a 4-inch gun, and we used to have a firing practice. That firing is a thrilling experience. And especially when we do the firing practice in the night time, that is a treat to watch. They will fire the target bullet first. So that will light, red light. That will be floating. And remaining bullets they will fire, that will be white in light. So it will be, that is the target, and they will start hitting that. It is a treat to watch. So
wow, great. I was not knowing that.
And these are the experiences, beautiful.
I think I need to schedule one more meeting. Maybe next month we will have one of your sessions. I'll club with somebody, and we'll have one more maybe 30-minute session. I think it's not enough. I think you have lots to share, right, Rajan sir? I think not many things.
Next time when I come, I will tell you the accidents and mishaps that happened, and how life is uncertain on board.
Right.
it's very important to have one more session. Yes.
Yes, we want to. I think we will not hear, we will not see in even movies or any place, right? This thing, I think it's, I've not heard about it, even though being with, you know, it's really great. We all of us should listen, and, you know, we will put this in YouTube and I'll clip even, the video.
My cousin is here. My nephews are here.
Wow.
This is the first time
I am
sharing this experience.
Oh, great.
Wonderful, sir.
With a great. This is the first time I am sharing this experience.
Great.
So I felt, you know, thrilled. So I changed the way I looked at my service. I changed the way I look at my life itself.
Yes.
So far, if I thought it was struggle, failure, and pain, only that I was seeing. Now, when I changed the way I looked at those pain and adventures, difficulties, challenges I faced, now altogether that has changed. I changed the way I looked at it. So it changed.
Yes.
It changed and it made me proud.
Proud, yes. We all are proud of you.
Glorious.
That really changed this whole, this one, my self-esteem, self-confidence, everything changed.
Yeah.
The moment I changed my mindset, yes. Once I changed, you know, everything changed.
Absolutely, so, sir. Great. I would say you have kept this hidden. That's totally wrong. You should have told this long back to people.
Yeah.
And so many would get motivated. We were doing engineering, and when we came out, nobody was there to help us because nobody knows what is engineering in our family. And, you know, nobody to guide us and everything. We slogged here and there so much. We were not doing particular direction and everything. If we had one mentor like you, who can guide us and you could take us to a different level. Today, I think we would have been millionaires. And, you know, it's not about money, I would say, you know, so many things to learn, which we don't get in today's scenario. We are always addicted to that social media, always thinking about that and everything, not ready to listen. Today, I think I will be playing this almost every time. Maybe it will go, you know, into the YouTube. And,
you know, Pradeep, the moment you said how important my presentation is there and how you value my presentation, really, it motivated me. You are the motivator, actually, for this.
No. It's not that, sir. Only thing is that I just tried to, you know, pinch you and just, you know, you need to get it open. You have a lot of khajana inside you, but you're not opening it. I really don't know. I think today is the moment which not only to yourself or to your family members, you have opened it to, you know, the outside media also, because we'll be putting it in Facebook, Insta, and all the places. People will start knowing you. They will approach you and, you know, they will ask you a lot of questions, which I think the people like us, we will not be able to know all these things. So I should really thank you about it. You know, it's a great thing. I really, you know, salute you for this great thing which you have shared today.
Thank you.
It has touched me and made me a lot emotional. I was just thinking, if I would have got one person 20 years back like you, I think I would have been in a different, different place. So thank you very much for that. And today I want you to sing a song for us, sir.
Yeah.
And then I will also share your contact details with everybody. Anybody needs to capture your details, they can go ahead and capture. But before that, please go ahead with the song, sir. Please. Thank you. If you want, you can have a glass of water, please.
I want to dedicate this song. Somewhere, I don't know, the moment I started singing recently, there is a wild dream in my mind. When this goes on social media, at least one or two of my friends of Navy will listen to that and remember me, and even they contact me. It is a wild dream, but I think it will come true.
No, it's not difficult. Just tell me their names. I will track them and I'll just cut this clip only and send them.
I don't worry,
I will edit it.
Those days, you know, I don't know where their address also, that thing. Anyway,
okay.
wild dream, but I dedicate this song for all those people who encouraged me to sing and sat and listened to my song hours together. So this song I dedicate to them. चलते चलते मेरे ये गीत याद रखना, कभी अलविदा ना कहना, कभी अलविदा ना कहना। रोते हंसते बस यूं ही तुम गुनगुनाते रहना, कभी अलविदा ना कहना, कभी अलविदा ना कहना। प्यार करते करते हम तुम कहीं खो जाएंगे, इन ही बहारों के आंचल में थक के सो जाएंगे। प्यार करते करते हम तुम कहीं खो जाएंगे, इन ही बहारों के आंचल में थक के सो जाएंगे। सपनों को फिर भी तुम यूं ही सजाते रहना, फिर कभी अलविदा ना कहना, कभी अलविदा ना कहना। चलते चलते मेरे ये गीत याद रखना, कभी अलविदा ना कहना, कभी अलविदा ना कहना। बीच रह में दिल भर बिछड़ जाए कहीं हम अगर, और सुनी सी लगे तुम्हें जीवन की डगर। बीच रह में दिल भर बिछड़ जाए कहीं हम अगर, और सुनी सी लगे तुम्हें जीवन की डगर। हम लौट आएंगे तुम यूं ही बुलाते रहना, कभी अलविदा ना कहना, कभी अलविदा ना कहना। चलते चलते मेरे ये गीत याद रखना, कभी अलविदा ना कहना, कभी अलविदा ना कहना। रोते हंसते बस यूं ही तुम गुनगुनाते रहना, कभी अलविदा ना कहना, कभी अलविदा ना कहना।
Great. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Wow, wow, wow. I think it is just like you have sung with your whole heart and everything, you know, it just like we thought it is just like we are in your ship. I was thinking we all were traveling in your INS Ganga.
Thank you.
I had that feeling, you know, totally. And you were telling us this story and all that things, right? We were in your ship, really. Thank you so much. Thank you so much.
I was reliving that experience. Thank you.
Thank you
all for spending great, that evening.
Yeah, great, amazing
for
experience.
For patient listening.
Absolutely, absolutely. Just in two days, I'll just put it in the, I mean to say, I'll upload to YouTube, maybe tomorrow itself by afternoon. And I'll send you a link so that you can distribute with all your family members. I'm so thankful to all of them who has joined today. I think whoever has not joined, maybe they have missed a lot. I've sent this invite to at least more than 20,000 people across social media and everything. But see, only a couple of them joined. That means to say everybody needs to have that bhagya also. Not everybody can get that, right? So we are all lucky people. I think we are getting so many things from this. And we will definitely share with, you know, each other. Just try to share with at least one or two people in and around your community or somewhere. Maybe there might be only at least one person who can definitely benefit from this, sir. Thank you very much for having a great impact. Yeah.
Thank you.
And lastly,
thank
I would
you.
Like to share. Yeah.
I also want to convey this message to all the members who are here. Mindset Club is an organization
for success.
And which is helping a person like me or anybody who wants to share your experience of life or your story or your plans or your activities you want to share to people, you need not pay anything. You can just become a member of this group and you can be in that WhatsApp group of this club. And yeah. Really, it is a very fantastic social work Pradeep Shetty has taken up. And see what happened. I could share this information with so many people.
Yeah.
So it is a platform which anybody can use. I request all of you to become a member of this and make use of it. Or at least you listen to people who have got stories to tell.
Yes.
So it may inspire you to do better. So thank you very much. I hope everybody will take up this.
Yeah, we will take a lot many things, sir. It's really amazing that we were able to connect with you.
Thank you.
I would just like to share your contact details with people.
Please, just sir.
Yeah.
I want to thank everyone who has participated. Thank you very much.
Yeah. Really great. That shows the true love which they have for you, sir.
Yeah, sir. Definitely. There are people who love me.
So, yeah. So you're able to see the screen, right? Right now?
Yeah, I can.
Yeah.
I can.
So the contact details of Mr. Narendra Naik, sir, is here. His email address, his phone number, his Instagram account, Facebook account, and LinkedIn. I request all of you to please go ahead and please connect with him. And if possible, just go to his Insta account and just leave a short message by saying, at least, thank you for this great story. It has changed my life. At least type in thank you. I think I would be greatly obliged. And also, I think we are doing justice to, you know, Narendra sir about it. So maybe in another hour, in 1 hour, I request all of you to please go into any of this account and just
they can give their feedback.
Yeah.
I request them to give their feedback so that it will help me to improve.
Okay. Yes.
Any thought, whatever they felt about my presentation, if they write up and give me, it will be a testimonial for me to start this new venture.
I think we should learn from you, sir. Nothing to give feedback. There are so many things we need to learn from you, sir. Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. So thank you all. My good wishes to everybody. And I hope, you know, this was a great, amazing session. And I really appreciate Prakash, sir. You know, really thank Prakash, sir. Even though being sitting in Chicago and early morning, he woke up today, you know, at 5 a.m. and he has joined this session. I think I need to give you a salute, sir. Really.
Oh, it's okay. It's okay. Don't worry about it. It's a pleasure to be in this group. Yes. And let me say a few things about Narendra.
You know what, Pradeep?
Yeah.
You know, Pradeep, what today he said, I will learn something from you. I want to tell him. It is the performance of his student he watched. He is my guru for English.
Wow. Great, sir.
When I was learning how to write a letter in English, I used to write a letter in English to him. He used to correct my letter and send it back to me.
Wow.
I used to correct my language.
Wow.
So
great,
that way,
great.
Now he should certify me whether I have learned English properly.
Yeah. Over to Prakash, sir.
Narendra, you'll have to certify me so that I can certify you. can I talk about a few minutes?
Please,
for
sir. Please, go ahead. It's your time.
Right. Please.
Naik family is a huge family. And Narendra we all grew up in the same time frame. I'm 49 born, he's 50 born, so there is a difference of 1 year. The point is that we grew up together in Baswan Gudi, Nayakwada, which is to be our grandfather's house. And Narendra in particular was my favorite of all some 50 odd cousins. He was my favorite. And we got along very well. Possibly because of the same age group. We are just 1 year here and there. And we shared a lot of common things like music. We were always playful. I used to go to Bangalore during vacations. Of course, I'm born in Bangalore. And Narendra was known for his antics. So that's a different story altogether. We'll have a separate session for that. But once he came to Jamnagar for his naval training, that's where we got much more closer. Because for off days, he used to come to Ahmedabad, where we used to live. And he was always very kind enough to bring a bottle of rum for me. So that's how we used to enjoy our nice evenings, because the state of Gujarat being a state of prohibition, having even an empty bottle in hand was a great pleasure. And Narendra used to come and bring that, and we used to have a lot of fun. I still remember having saved one of his gifts, naval gifts. It used to be a muffler cum cap, I remember, in navy blue. And I don't know, after moving some 18 houses, I lost track where it was. But Narendra has been a hallmark, I would say, no amount of struggle can pull him down. His spirit is always high. He's always a fighting spirit. And he will never say, okay, I lost it, I can't do it. He will never give up. And that's one of the most inspiring things which Narendra exhibits. And I'm very, very happy that he's my cousin. All the nephews, one of them is sitting here, it's been a great pleasure. And all the nieces and nephews, I love them all. And Narendra and Bharati, you have to write a love story about them. like Leela and Majnu.
Yeah.
So that's another story, another episode.
yeah, surely.
That is the biggest story.
Yes, you know, you have to learn from him how to evade parents-in-law in Dharwad bus stand.
Oh, is it? Oh, so many things are coming up, Narendra sir. Okay, we will need another session with you, all these things.
No, you should make a movie off of him.
Yes.
You should make a Hindi movie out of him, out of his story. That will be a great one, because he's full of adventures, let me tell you that.
Yes.
Yeah, my life is full of adventures. There is no doubt. I got quite a number of adventures throughout my life.
Yes.
I love adventures.
That is because you always wanted to get into trouble.
Not so trouble.
Because you created your own adventures.
No, I might have trouble. I might have created trouble for others, but it was an adventure for me.
Yeah. So that's always a pleasure.
Thank you, Prakash. Thank you.
God bless you. No.
Thank you. Narendra. Thank you, Prakash.
Thank you. Very, very could much. Be more helpful to you.
Sure. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
I love you, Prakash. I love you.
Love you all, everybody here.
Anybody else?
Thank you
very much. Anybody else would like to share anything about Narendra, sir? Any of your relatives, cousins?
Anybody want to talk?
Yeah, this is Jagan here.
Yeah, please.
Hi, Jagan.
Hi, sir. Good evening, Naik, sir.
Good evening, Jagan.
Good evening.
Come on.
Sir, I feel very lucky to have you as a colleague in Divishri. I never knew. I know you are ex-serviceman, but I never knew all about this. I really thank you, this platform also, to make us to know about you. And it's really a nice time, sir. I don't know.
Thank you very much, Jagan.
I just wanted to add one more thing, if I could.
Yeah, please, go ahead, sir.
While Narendra was the only one among us to be a part of the 71 war, I was also participating in the war, in the sense that I had my first job with Abbott Laboratories. And for some reason, the company chose to continue with their sales training program for new hirees in Bombay. And I used to be there. We were stationed at a hotel called Hotel Delamar by Churchgate on Marine Drive. And which was exactly our opposite of Talk of the Town Hotel.
Okay.
But our hotel was facing the Marine Drive. And the war started and no lights. So we had to study under candlelight for 17 days. We were studying for a training program in candlelight. And the midnight, it has to be, you have to kill the light. Candlelight. So we were kind of, you know, it's also kind of a war for us. Of course, no bullets were flying. That's a different story. But
total blackout.
But the blackout and other things, that was a different kind of adventure for us. But anyway, glad to be a part of that period. And the thrill that we all had about war. We were volunteering in the city of Ahmedabad so that people didn't run their scooters and motorcycles or bicycles with lights on. We used to force the car drivers to turn off the lights. All those things was a part of thrill for us.
Absolutely.
And the exhibition of patriotism was a small thing at the time. So that's how we had a lot of fun there.
Great, sir. Great.
Yeah.
Great, amazing experience, even during blackout and everything.
Thank you, Jagan.
Thank you very much,
yes, sir.
And thank you, Jagan, sir.
Jagan, thank you very much.
Yeah, even though, see, he's in the car and is driving, but I really appreciate your great attitude towards joining, sir. Really great. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Back, thank you.
Yeah, and I also appreciate and thanks everybody who has joined this session. And I request all of you to, you know, you can get a few of your people or anybody, maybe seniors, or it doesn't matter whoever he or she is, you can join with us in our Facebook, in our WhatsApp group. And we also have a Facebook community, the New Mindset Community. You can please join. And this will always be a free platform where you can go ahead and share your experiences with us, your failures, your success. So all of us can, you know, really learn from each other and, you know, face the situations. Whatever you have faced, maybe in a much easier way by yourself mentoring many people. So Narendra, sir, you are an icon of many people right now. So you just need to be ready with your book as soon as possible and start giving, you know, lectures, online lectures, and, you know, just being on the platform continuously. Yeah. Don't think you're retired and you need to rest or anything. No, don't think of it. You need to be continuously in the platform, online platform.
Nothing like that.
Yeah. We are always there to help you in any way possible. Yeah, to reach out to anybody, anytime, Zoom meeting, anything, we are always ready for you, sir. So thank you all. I wish you all a very happy, you know, weekend. And I hope you all will be, you must have loved this session. And I request you, once you get the YouTube link, please share with at least 5 of your friends and nearby colleagues. Okay. Thank you very much, sir. And especially Prakash, sir, you got up so early.
No. It's okay.
So much for your dedication, sir.
My pets wake me up anyways, you know.
Yeah. And also to Mr. Jagan Reddy, sir. Thank you very much, sir. Thank you very much. I appreciate. Thank you. Yeah. Take care. And anything else? Narendra, sir, you want to say anything? Yeah.
I want to thank everybody. That's all.
Oh, yeah. Thank you. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you. Take care. Bye-bye. Thanks.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye. Bye. Thank you.
Bye.